Hello. In the previous episodes, I showed the making of 8 different pawns, the bishops, rooks, and the queen for my Twisty Puzzle chess set. Now I'm making the king, which will look like this. It will still be a 2x2, of course, but since it's a king, I decided to add a special non-twisty element, which will become clearer later. So let's see how I got there. As with all of the others, I'm using the same bottom parts and just making a new top. Here you can see half a cross section of the two together. Notice how there's no cross at this stage. If I get rid of the bottom, you can see what I did next. I used SketchUp's Follow Me tool and made it round, though only through 90 degrees. Obviously there will be 4 of these and they will go together like this. The hole in the top is where the non-twisty element will go, so each one needs some further work. This is the cross part which will fit into that hole. With these modifications to the 4 pieces, it can only be inserted in one way. In addition, you must decide where the 4 pieces go in relation to each other when solving the base 2x2 puzzle. Simply putting them all at the top isn't enough. With the design finished, it's now a case of packing the pieces as closely as possible together and uploading the file to Shapeways, who will 3D print the masters for me. Then I can make moulds and cast the pieces. The 3D printed king parts have now arrived from Shapeways. Let's break the pieces apart. So I'm just going to tidy up the parts and remove these joining pieces. After attaching the universal middle pieces, I can now make the moulds. T28 silicon rubber from UK company Tranti is poured into little boxes made from polystyrene sheet. I'm using a T5 fast catalyst, which makes the rubber set faster. I will leave it overnight in a warm place and it will be ready in the morning. The rubber has now set and I can remove it from the boxes before taking the masters out of the moulds. I'm tidying up the moulds and removing any loose rubber that will affect the casting later. 4 out of the 5 moulds look good so far, but this one is a reject. I think the master had come a bit loose, so there was too much rubber sort of went over it, so it's just not going to be any good. Right, so that one's looking good as well. And the third one. This is where things get a little bit complicated because this shape is quite weird. It's kind of got lots of cuts and stuff. So what you tend to do, you attempt to take it out by loosening it up. But you kind of know that it's probably not going to come out like that. Now I believe cutting it makes it technically a split mould, but I'd have to check that. By doing it this way, it won't affect the moulding later, sorry, the casting later, but it will allow the pieces to come out. Wow, that kind of looks a bit complicated in there. To be honest with you, I'm not that confident about this. It looks a bit messy, but I'm going to keep going. But if it doesn't work, then I'm basically learning from the way I'm doing it. So then if I may have to make another mould and I cut it again, the next time I'll cut it better and it will work. That feels good. That thing is coming out now. Right, so we've got the shape out. So just a reminder of how kind of complicated this shape is and why it didn't want to come out of the mould. Right, now for the casting. Once again I'm using wire from white paper clips as a reinforcement since the parts will be thin and fragile.
This is a mould for the cross part. I need to make sure the resin goes into every corner, so that's why I'm holding it like this. Poking a wire in also helps. I'm sure the experts use complicated vents, but I can't be bothered with all that. An elastic band to hold it together, and it's done, hopefully.
The resin has now gone hard, and I'm ready to take the castings out of the moulds. Now, obviously, one of these big ones is missing because I need to redo the rubber, but I'll come back to that later. So let's see how these king pieces look. Just going to tidy up around them. I don't want all this sort of loose stuff getting inside the molds for the next casting. Right, so now I can demold. So that's come out pretty good. Needs to be tidied up a bit. So I'll take out the other parts and then sort of see how they all fit together. I will just jump onto this one because this is the one that might well not work. And if it doesn't work, I'll have to do it in a mold it in a different way or cut it in a different way. I just kind of feel as though this one might be a complete nightmare because the shape is just really awkward. The plastic isn't going to be as strong as the 3D printed material, so I have to be a lot more careful taking it out of this than I did earlier. Oh, well, actually, that's not too bad. Actually, that's brilliant. I was expecting a load of air bubbles. Got a little tiny air bubble underneath the cross, but that can easily be filled up. So, yeah, I'm very pleased with that. And because that will eventually fit kind of in there, like that, when everything's sort of tidied up and cleaned. So, yeah, that's pretty good. Earlier I showed this mould of a king piece that didn't come out very well. I've now since replaced it and I think that's looking a lot better. So let's remove the master.
Yes, that's fine, and I was able to cast the final king piece, which you can see here alongside the others. Now for assembly. I'm starting with the four bottom parts, which are identical on every chest piece. A needle dipped into super glue is the best way to apply it to small areas. Now for the tops. It's very important that these are attached accurately, or the final cross part won't fit into the puzzle. That's why I am using a ruler as a set square. In theory, there should only be one way to attach the parts, but you always get inaccuracies creeping in during mould making and casting. My biggest concern is that these parts will lean away from each other slightly. However, once two are attached and sit almost touching, you know they are going to be okay. Third piece looking good. Fourth piece, and hopefully the cross can then be inserted without any issues. So that's the king now assembled and finished. Just a quick look at it. I think it looks okay. There is a bump there that I'm not too happy about, but I was really concerned about like getting these four pieces really tightly together. Otherwise, the cross wouldn't really work very well. But basically, that's just my inaccuracy, that there's a bump there. So I just want to go through the design again. So to remove the cross, you turn it anti-clockwise, lift it, anti-clockwise, lift it. So when you're solving, you obviously have to get those four pieces in the right position, because round the outside, they look identical. So the solver wouldn't necessarily know where they go in relation to each other. I will just scramble it and solve it to sort of show you that thing further. It also gives me a chance to check whether there's any sort of clashing going on, and I think it's okay. Right, now I'm going to start with the highest piece, and obviously as a designer I know how this goes. So the next highest piece goes to there, and then that piece goes into there, and then obviously the last piece goes into the last place. Right, so if you're solving this for the first time, you would now want to check whether the cross goes into it. So to there, twist, down, twist. Now it has the final twist because if it just, I mean, it looks okay like that, but then if you're playing chess and using it, it's gonna be loose. So I put the final twist in that goes like that to hold it into place. So you can just pick up the piece there if you wanted to. Now obviously that blocks movements. You still got that movement, but not the other movement. So you'd need to take that out and then solve the bottom, which of course is dead simple 2x2 corners. Like that. And now you can put in the top again, lock it into place, and there's the finished king.